So now I'm asking you the first question. What inspired, what inspired you to start this, enter this business?
Right. Actually, sir, for 20 years after MBA, I joined so many MNC companies, especially in FMCG as well as the pharmaceutical field. So after 20 years, I got the practical exposure of the market, developing the strategy and its implementation. After that, for the next level of my self-satisfaction, I decided that I have achieved the sufficient level of, you can say, the information as well as the hands-on experience. I must do something extra just to support the newcomers, the entrepreneurs, the small businessmen. So you can say for better utilization of whatever my skill, whatever experience I have gained from the market, from the big company. So that's why I started this business.
What is your core business?
Pardon?
What is your core business?
My core business is business strategy consulting, especially for pharmaceutical, herbal, OTC medicine, as well as the FMCG, as well as you can say consumer goods, any consumer goods company or product, or especially focusing over the entrepreneur, those who are thinking just to launch their new business, particularly in this field. Along with that, side by side, two more verticals are there. The first, it is the political consulting, branding and image building. That is the parallel consulting vertical.
What are the unique strengths of your company?
We are having a core team having experience of minimum of 15 years. This is first USP of our, you can say, the company or our team. The second important that we are having very much expertise over whatever the practical obstacles. See, launching any business, it is not a problem. But establishing your footprint into the market and penetrating the market and developing the new customer, you can say the sell out your product among, you can say, the competition. When competition, especially in India, competition level is very much high. So this micro level of strategic understanding of market dynamics, it is our core USP.
What have been the major achievements of your company?
We have established so many, you can say, the newcomer type of the business, those for the first time entered into pharmaceutical as well as the FMCG industry, very, very small type of, but small type of the entrepreneurs, but they are maintaining very much healthy kind of the turnover. So our USP, our more and more interest is, especially the small type of the entrepreneurs, those who are not aware or don't know how to fight the big MNCs, MNC player in market. So we have established so many clients.
How much strong is your brand?
The niche branding, that definitely our consulting or individual as myself in niche branding, definitely we are a well established, and so many people as well as industry person, they are well aware about our work as well as our brand recognition. We are at least, you can say, the satisfied. We can rank that myself, whatever I have invested and whatever I have gained, we are well satisfied.
How do we look at the opportunities?
It is very excellent opportunity. I can say for the first time, India is going to see some such kind of the golden opportunity, especially for the entrepreneurship. And this is the demand of time that India should produce more and more entrepreneurs rather than just depending on MNCs or big GNs, those who are already having a well-established market. This is one thing. The second important thing, India is going to become especially the hub for manufacturing hub, especially for the pharmaceutical. The government of India, their main effort is to develop India as a manufacturing hub for the for the pharmaceutical as well as the herbal OTC medicine, not to fulfill the demand of inside Indian market as well as for export market, you can say, the across the world. This is second important thing. The third important thing, the lucrativeness of Indian market in terms of opportunity, that all three, four things, it is available here. The big market size, you can manufacture here your medicines or your product, you are getting a ready-made market, 1.2 billion population, that is the consumer base. The second important thing, very educated, you can say, the professionals, whether it is marketing, manufacturing, scientists, research center. Third important thing, very much active, proactive government support right now, it is available. You can expand your wings starting from India, from a small city to the entire, you can say, the world. So this is very attractive thing, whatever it looks to me, especially for pharma, FMCG or herbal industry.
What would you like to say about your team and associates?
we should focus more and more over entrepreneurship as well as the innovations rather than just looking only for the job. Definitely, if you have did the job for 10 year, 20 year, and you are going to feel a level of, you can say, the satisfaction, you must go into the market as an expert consultant, and you should show the way to other, the way of the success to others, so that India can be a world leader. Because of, as already I have told, it is time to produce more and more entrepreneur rather than just going to be the CEO of any company or MD, or you can say the national manager of any company.
Who are your blue chip clients?
All small clients are blue chip clients, not only for me, but for the, you can say, the country also. Because of the formation of or establishment of any blue chip company, the starting point, it is very small. So every client, whatever, whether it is the smallest type of the client, I see the potential that they will be one of the biggest blue chip client in coming future.
You come from MNC background, so you don't feel that you are talking to small clients.
Actually, this is a psychological state of the mind, especially the Indian professionals, what they do feel. But I think if you are going to join any small company, or if you are working with a small company entrepreneurs, you are getting more and more facilities as well as the span, or you can say the area, to utilize your talent in comparison of big MNCs. In big MNCs company, no matter whatever your position is there, your freedom, your work space, it is very much limited. You are very much content. You are not having very much space to play, you can say, in a free manner. So if you want to get a satisfaction as well as whatever knowledge you have gained, you want to omit in market, then definitely going for the new customers, new client, as well as the small client or medium size of the client, 50 crore, 100 crore, 200 or 500 crore turnover type of the client. They will provide you the excellent platform because of lots of growth opportunities available there, as well as the innovation may be possible. You can show your innovative skill there. But in big MNCs where market is fully tapped, market is fully packed, I don't think that there is very much, you can say, the very much free space you will find to play.
What is the secret of your success?
Micro-level understanding of uncontrolled factor of the business. In any business, there are two kind of the dynamics or factor or environment, you can say. First, it is the controlled. Second, it is the uncontrolled. In controlled, we can consider that manufacturing. Because of third-party manufacturing, it is available. You can get the product manufactured, quality product manufactured by anyone. But the, you can say, untold, unseen risk, as well as uncontrolled factors are when you enter into market, nobody knows what will happen. The better you are having the understanding on some such kind of the uncontrolled dynamics of any business, more and more successful yield will be there, more and more guarantee will be there for the success. So we are having very the extraordinary type of the command over unseen challenges, unseen, you can say, the dynamics of the market. Definitely it is the marketing as well as the sales, branding, all these things. Because of revenue generation, it is possible only and only through the marketing, sales, branding, and all these things. Rest of other thing, it is only the investment. For example, if you are going for manufacturing, it will be investment. But from which action you are going to get return of your investment, that is the marketing and sales. Understanding the market dynamics, as well as the nature of its component. Component of market means there is the consumer, there is the marketplace, as well as there is the product, there is the competitor. In a nutshell, you must have to understand the micro dynamics of all these four or five components of the market, that how they behave, then and then any business house can get the success.
What are your suggestions to the entrepreneurs?
My suggestions for the entrepreneurs, the first suggestion that if you are engaged in any job, this is the right time to shift as an entrepreneur. This is one thing. The second important thing, if you are going for any kind of the business, better before investing, you should try to understand the market dynamics. Because of investment, it is very much easy. Anybody, one who is having money, they can invest. This is the first thing. The second thing, how your money will get returned to you, that comes only with the help of strong marketing as well as the sales policy as well as the philosophy. So before entering into any market, any product market, you must understand the micro dynamics of market, so that whatever you are going to, you can say, the establish your business, success will be more and more success you can get as a return.
What are your suggestions to the government?
In comparison of other economies, likewise, we have to face the competition with China, as well as in terms of technology and all these things. We are facing the challenges as well as the competition with the Western countries. Of course, government must have to provide leverage as well as making, you can say, the business process more and more easy. The government is doing all these things, you can say, the clerical type of the system, the time schedule should be minimized, single window scheme is there, but it is not very much effective. We have to maximize the effectiveness of entire government procedure. Government is taking sufficient type of the, you can say, at least principle based changes, whatever it is required, just to making business process more and more easy as well as the feasible. But the practical implementation, it should be more and more fast from the government side. This is only the my suggestion. Ground zero level implementation, so that the investor as well as the consumer should realize the impact of government policies, so that we can become the world leader. If we have to face the Chinese economy, Western economies, then definitely we have to perform at par from government side, from private players, on each and every dimension we have to perform at par.
How do you foresee the future?
As I have already told, I think the golden period of India, it is going to start in terms of economy, because of there are the certain kind of the reason, as in my earlier question I told, India is only some such a place where you can find all the necessary factor for success at one place. Big market, 1.2 billion population, all these are the consumer, talent is available here, high level of professionalism, it is available, government support is available there. Technology, it is also available. So I can say that future of, you can say, economic future of India, it is very bright. Only the subject is that all the factors, likewise the government as well as the private player as well as the consumer, every person, we must have to play very seriously.
Any other important point or highlight you may like to share?
Yeah, definitely. I would like to share that this is a typical, you can say, the come out from the typical mentality of Indian mentality, likewise just doing 10 to 5 p.m. job, because of as a job, as a, you can say, the holding any position, NSM, CEO, if you can generate the revenue of 1,000 crore rupees, if you can manage, why not you are going to utilize all these things to for your country, for yourself. If you can establish a brand in market, brand means the other company or other person's product as a brand, if it can be established by yourself, why you are not treating yourself as a brand? Whatever skill you are using for other MNC, foreign companies, use all those for yourself to make yourself as a brand, or maximum you can say that use all these your skill for Indian companies, so that in real term after 30 years, 20 years, India can become, you can say,